What is going on, everybody? Welcome back. Sorry I haven't put a video up. I've actually been getting the boat fixed up because it was out of commission for a little bit, and I was having an issue with the battery not keeping charge, you know. And then I replaced the battery. I took it out one time just to test it, come back, and then it was dead again. So really couldn't figure out what was going on. I took it to the shop. I left it there. They did the service maintenance on it. They fixed it. They found out what was going on. It wasn't keeping charge. So then they fixed that. They also just redid fixed the wiring that was going on with it. And now it's running good. The only thing left they have to do is just change the radio out, because that thing's busted and they already got a new one coming. And that's just a plug I had to pull in and pull out. So it's not a big deal. But other than that, she's running great. And we're ready to get out, get some fishing. You know, I really don't know what to expect. I haven't been out in over a month. So what I'm gonna do is I'm probably gonna shoot out and go get some bait. And then I brought a chum block with me. I bought some chum bait too, just stuff I had in the freezer. I'm just gonna use it all up and just get ready for the new season. And we'll see what we catch. You know, if we can get some Spanish mackerel, or we can get on some snapper, I'll be happy. You know, and just really want to just run the boat today and test it out and just, you know, just push it and see to make sure. Oh, we also installed the kill switch at the bottom here. Let's see if you can see it. Now with that kill switch, what I do is whenever I park the boat, I'll just shut it off to kill it, hit the switch, and then there'll be no more battery issues. You know, that was just kind of like a precaution I wanted to add to it, just because I didn't want to run into no more issues, you know. I have been having battery issues for some time now, like the last three trips. I had to jump it with a jumper, and just one of the trips I had to leave it running. I just didn't want to mess with it anymore. But I'm going out fishing. I got Alvin with me. Alvin.
Hey.
We're going to get out there. We're going to get on it. We're going to see if we can have some fun and catch some dinner, catch some fish, and catch you guys in a little bit. All right, we got a few here. There we go. There we go. Okay. All right. And a pinfish. All right, we got all the bait we need. We always come back and get more if we need it. But, and we got a pinfish. Can't go wrong with that. Look at these pretty pilchards, exactly what we wanted. Big, beautiful. Let's get these in the bucket. See where the flats are, like where it drops down, and the channel here. We're going to anchor up on one of these ledges. I don't know which one yet. And right now we're in about 18 feet of water, but we're gonna anchor up on one of these ledges here and just hang tight and see if we could bring out of this channel. Out here you can see, got some bait in the back, some ballyhoo, some snapper. I missed my mark, so I was going back and forth. I finally landed on it. So we're like at 10 feet and then it drops down to like 20 feet. I wish I would've got closer, but I already anchored up, already got the chum out. I'm gonna try this spot for about an hour. If it doesn't give me great results, I know we're gonna get fish, but I wanna get really good fish, quality fish, then I'll push out a little bit further. All right, let's see if we can get something nice. Guy. It's not that little, nice little snapper. All right. Oh, you're on one too? There we go. I'd rather have the fish than the bait, but hey. Yeah. Nice little snapper.
A yellowtail?
No, it's a little mangrove. Whoa. This thing just started taking off. Probably a jack. Oh no. Oh, it's a humongous snapper. Oh my gosh. Big and fat. Yo, look at the size of this one. Huge. We want the big ones in the back. Setup I'm running, just basic knocker rig. Maybe a half ounce, quarter ounce weight, straight to a 2-0 circle hook. My bait died. I didn't put fresh water in it. I left the aerator, but you know, you can keep them alive by adding fresh water. I didn't. I was trying to find a good spot, and then, you know, by the time I realized they're dead, but they still work, they're still fresh. So what I'm doing is just take them, I'm hooking them through, and just throwing it past the chum slick back there. And seeing what hits, you know? I left my home in Georgia, headed for the Frisco Bay, yeah. Ooh. All right. This guy's small. This is literally a lane snapper spot, huh? Yes. Pretty. Oh yeah. These are good. These only have to be 8. They only have to be 8.
I gotta buy new gloves. If something happened, it's like a stickiness on the gloves.
Oh yeah.
We're stuck together.
What?
Yeah.
Oh, it melted.
Yeah.
It melted the rubber.
Or something.
Yeah. Something's flying over there.
The weather was nice today.
Yeah, the weather's great today. Oh, that was my fault. That's what happens when you mess around.
Took half of
it. I lost it. I lost it. Whoa. That was huge. I screwed up with that one, boys. Messing around my phone. Oh. That is disappointing. Uh-oh. Yeah. Now we're talking. Yeah. This light tackle stuff is so much fun. You know, always feels good. You feel everything. Nice big old pretty snappers. Yeah, humongous. That's what we're after. That's what we're after.
That's nice one, man.
Yeah. I knew this spot's gonna be good. Yeah. Look at that, boys. Big, gorgeous snapper on light tackle. You can't go wrong with it. Big fish out here. Here we go again. Swallow it. Got him. Not as big, but still fun. Nice little size. You just see everything behind it, trying to pick up what it's eating. Throwing him back though. We need to go get live bait and just hightail it back over here. We're not that far from the bait spot. Cause this is a great, great spot. Maybe I should just save this spot and just keep moving, right? Find another one. Ooh. Now we're talking. A little bit smaller, but put a good oomph.
Oh, that's another one. Oh, that's good.
Just wonder where those big old lanes are. See all the bait down here? Little blue runners and pinfish, ballyhoo, just about everything.
Hey everybody. All right, so we got a bunch of snapper, two really big ones, couple really big hits. So I saved this spot. I wanna come back because I wanna use live bait, possibly. So what we're gonna do, is we're gonna run over there. We're gonna get some live bait. And then we're going to go to a different spot. I want to stay in this area, so let me show. I'm going to stay around here and then see where it goes flat in that channel. That's, I think I'm going to fish that channel over there, probably anchor up at the edge somewhere, and then see if we could draw anything out, because that drops like 20 feet over there, so 18 feet. So I'm going to just, we're going to go with some live bait, and then we're going to get back out and see if we can catch some more fish. See you in a little bit.
Oh, that's beautiful.
Right there. Yeah. Nah, no, we ain't gonna get them. I know. It's a whole family of them. What's up, guys? Oh, these guys are smart, man. They... Awesome. Bunch of pilchards right here.
Wait, talk to them real quick. They can be out of here.
Awesome. That's real shallow, right? So this is like super low tide. What we're doing is we found a pocket like in the flats here, and we're going to just anchor on the edge and just fish in this channel. It's like a channel, a little just a break off within the actual main channel here, and we're gonna give it a shot. And we're gonna see if it works. I've never fished here before, so I don't know what to expect, but I'm really excited about it because I've gone through here a couple times and I was like, man, it'd be pretty cool if I just anchor up on the ledge here. And now that it's low tide, is probably the best time to do it. So I'm gonna anchor up and we'll fire the camera back on and we'll see what we get. For here is, I put a pinfish, no weight, to a 5-0 circle hook. To see if we can get something on that mid column range, you know? We're gonna put them out over there. That's a little bit closer than I want, but. And then we'll see if there's anything there worth the squeeze. I don't know if you can see the ballyhoo or not. I saw a really big shark. I couldn't tell what it was. It came up and went down, and that's it. So let's get fishing. Should be throwing it in a little bit deeper in the channel. So this is the little pocket. There's the main channel here. I don't know if you can see it. I hope you can. That's just ballyhoo. But you see that main channel, you see the channel markers, and it goes all the way around back there towards like Bay Keys, or you can run like Call the Channel, Bluefish Channel, Jack Channel, right? So in between these, you have like these little pocket channels, and oh, they busted yours up. Nice, they're here. Yep. And so we're in one of the little pocket finger channels. I don't even know what to call it. We got a live pinfish, and then we have Alvin's doing a he's got a knocker rig too, dropping straight down, and I got a one as well for the pilchards. So we got current against the wind too, which is a little bit weird here. Something on here. Nice little laner. I Oh, this is not, yeah. Mutton, it's a lane snapper. Real pretty. Put him back. I like lane snapper. Real tasty. Here goes all of our bally here too. Oh my God, I can't believe this guy actually jumped out. All right, we set up shop somewhere else. We moved from that other location. Just, I want to hit it again, but maybe at night, evening time, because I think that'd be a great tarpon spot, you know? So I marked it. I'm not going to go anytime soon. You know, I'll wait and try it maybe next season for tarpon when they come in. I know they're there. You know, we have our residential ones, but I think that's a really good spot because those channels push from the Gulf, right? And it pushes in. So I know there's good fish that flush into it. I just don't think I hit it at a good time of day. So I came back to a different spot here, chumming up the water again. I got that pinfish on the top, just kind of sitting there. And then just waiting to see if something, if we get any bait. If we get any bait on the chum here. I see in the back, I don't know if you can see, I'm gonna try to point right at it right there. We've got ballyhoo, some pinfish. So everything's kind of starting to make its way. And then something's messing with this one, which is the pinfish. So I'm sure it's, I don't know, maybe a little ballyhoo or something trying to take it, or a needlefish. We'll find out. You know, something slams it, then it's game time. But other than that, we're here and we're going to, let's see, we're going to catch some fish. You know, it's 1:30 in the afternoon, so it's hot. Hot and I've been drinking a ton of water, but you can still feel the heat kicking in, you know. So I've been checking up on this guy back here, making sure he's all right. He says he's good. I gotta take care of the old man, you know, but he said he's kicking, he's doing all right. And let's see if we can catch some fish. Monstrous. Let me turn the radio off. This is huge, bro. I don't know what it is. All I know is this thing took off. Whoa. Jesus.
You're holding on, huh?
Yeah, holding on for dear life. My 20-pound leader that got chafed on the way in. I'm sitting there jamming out to Jimmy Buffett and this thing starts cranking. Let's see what it is. Maybe a huge barracuda. I mean, I just want to see it. I don't know if I'm going to. What is that? Oh, it's a shark.
Yeah, it's a shark. It's right there.
Oh, cool. A little bonnet head. Cool.
Shark.
All right. Yeah. Little bonnet head shark. Those are fun. Yeah, hopefully don't break my line. I need it. No. I'll let you go. Hold on. I'll let you go. Hold on.
Hammerhead, right?
No, it's a bonnet head.
Oh.
Bonnet head.
Which is the one that's called hammer? Oh, no, it's longer.
Yeah, look at
the
this.
Hammerhead has what looks like an actual hammer.
Yeah.
Wow.
Feels nice. I knew something. I thought it was going to be a cooter or something, you know, the way it was ripping. I'll let you go. Chill out. There we go. Real good looking shark. Nice bonnet head. All right, back safe and sound.
That That was a beauty.
That was nice, right?
They look like, I've seen them in pictures, but I've never seen them.
That drag was screaming, huh?
Yeah.
Always fun to catch a little shark. It felt more barracuda-ish, but I had a feeling it was something with teeth. Just had that umph to it, you know? So we're down to a few baits. I'm burnt. I'm tired. I'm just hanging out just to, because even though it's really hot, it's a nice breeze and it feels really good. We're gonna go in now. Maybe one more fish. Maybe, but yeah, it feels a little sharkish. Last piece of bait too, that's the funny part. All right, I'm gonna take it easy. This is a bigger fish than that, even that shark. Could be a sting. No, a stinger would keep running. Yeah, big, bigger. I think it's a shark. Yeah, it feels like a shark. Dang. That's a shark, man. Really? Yeah, I know. Trying to wear him out. I want it to break. I only got a 20 pound leader on this one. I don't know. It's a shark. I just want to see what type. I don't want to pull too hard. There you go. I'm gaining on him. This is nice. He's tired now. I'm just surprised. If it's a shark, how come he ain't bit it off yet? I mean, it feels sharkish. Hold on, he's fighting back. Hold on. He's got another wind. Hold on, he's got a second wind. This is gonna be a long fight. Yeah, me too. Oh! We'll never know. Something with it was a shark. Ah.
Took the whole thing out, right?
Took the whole thing. Yeah.
Oh, you had it for a while too.
I know.
Oh man.
Yeah. That would be that.
For a couple of minutes.
He was big.
I don't think that was a snapper. It probably was a shark again.
No, that was a shark, yeah. All right. Before we headed in, we just want to cruise around Sunken Sailboat here, which is pretty cool because that means it might be a really cool fishing spot. If we could fish here. But you can see it's just down there. Goes down pretty deep. Guarantee you there's fish down there. I sanded on the GPS. We're gonna hit that spot next time. We'll ride over here and come try it out, you know? Never know. All right. The marina, just hanging out, real beautiful, gorgeous day. Spent some quality time on the water and really got to run the boat. You know, just had a fun time. You know, we had a fun time fishing, and then I probably spent an hour and a half just playing around, just riding around, you know. And then that's how I found that sailboat, which was pretty cool. I definitely want to go to that spot and try it out, because I'm sure that there's got to be something down there, you know, at least just worth bending the rod to, you know, maybe a big old group or something. So I'll come by one day. I'll bring, you know, a really heavy rod with me, and just see if something big down there, you know, that we can bring out. But I had a good time, guys. I'm gonna go home. We caught some good snappers, some big ones. The shark was fun. And hold on, my father-in-law doesn't know how to do the boat trailer. Maybe I shouldn't let him do this. Let's watch him. Oh no, he doesn't know how to do it. Anyways, let me go help him out,